Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we are going to learn about the decibel scale, which is commonly used in electronics and communication system. And we will also see the different decibel scales like dBm, dBW and dBV. Now I am sure many of you are already knowing about this decibel scale and how it is being used in electronics and communication systems. In fact, in the earlier videos of filter design, we have also used this decibel scale, right? But sometimes we are getting confused with this decibel scale, particularly when we are representing the voltage and power gain in terms of this decibel. So let us clear all this confusion in this video. So this decibel scale is basically a logarithmic scale which defines the ratio of two quantities, and particularly in electronics, it is being used to represent the voltage or power gain of particular amplifier system or electronic system. And if we talk about the communication system, in communication system, this decibel scale is used to represent the attenuation that is being provided by particular channel. And this decibel scale is also used to represent the voltage and power as well. Now, whenever this decibel scale is used to represent the power gain or power, then you will see that the factor of 10 is being multiplied with this logarithmic scale. And likewise, whenever it is being used to represent the amplitude or voltage, then you will see the factor of 20 that is being multiplied with this logarithmic scale. So whenever it is being used with the voltage, then the factor of 20 is getting multiplied with this logarithmic scale. And whenever it is being used with the power, then factor of 10 is being multiplied with this logarithmic scale. Now the reason is that this power is proportional to the square of the voltage. So that is the reason whenever you are representing any voltage or voltage gain, then it is being multiplied by the factor of 20 with this logarithmic scale. So first of all, now let us talk about the power gain and let us see how this power gain can be represented in a decibel form. So let us say we have an amplifier which is providing a power gain of 10. That means whenever you are applying an input of 1 watt, then at the output you will get an output power of 10 watt. So in decibel it can be represented as 10 log of capital G, where G represents the gain of this amplifier. That means 10 log of 10, which will be equal to 10 dB. And whenever the gain of the amplifier is 1, that means output is equal to input. At that time, if you see, the gain in decibel will be equal to 10 log of 1, that is equal to 0 dB. So in this way, we can represent the different gains in a decibel. So when the gain is 0, it represents the 0 dB. Whenever gain is 10, it represents the 10 dB. Likewise, we can represent the different gains in decibel. So as you can see here, every time whenever the gain is being multiplied by the factor of 10, you will see the increase in gain by a 10 dB. Now the advantage of representing this gain in decibel is that the larger quantities like 10 to the power 8, 10 to the power 9 can be easily represented in just 2 or 3 digits. And it is particularly useful when you have multiple amplifiers in your system. So let us say here we have two amplifiers which are being cascaded. So let's say if first amplifier is having a gain of A1 and the second amplifier is having gain of A2, then the overall gain will be equal to A1 in A2. Now let's say if A1 is equal to 10 to the power 4 and A2 is equal to 10 to the power 5, then the overall gain will be equal to 10 to the power 9. But if we represent this gain in decibel, then the A1 will be equal to 10 log of 10 to the power 4, which is nothing but 40 dB. And likewise, this gain A2 will be equal to 10 log of 10 to the power 5, which will be equal to 50 dB. And the overall gain will be the summation of these two gain, that is 40 plus 50, that is 90 dB. So whenever you have a multiple amplifiers in your system, then if you represent them in decibel, then it is easy to find the overall gain of that system. And the larger gain can be easily represented in this decibel form. So now if your system is having a gain of 2, then in decibel it can be represented as 10 log of 2, which will be approximately equal to 3 dB. So let's say if I have one amplifier which provides me the gain of A1 dB, and if I add the another amplifier which simply multiplies the gain by a factor of 2, then I can say that the overall gain will be equal to A1 plus 3 dB. So in this way, in any system, whenever the input is being multiplied by the factor of 2, then we can say that the gain that is being added to the system is 3 dB. Similarly, let us say we have one particular system which provides with the attenuation. So whenever you are providing the input of 1 watt, then at the output you are getting a 0.1 watt. So we can say that the gain of the system is 0.1. So in decibel, if we represent it, then it can be represented as 10 log of 0.1, that is equal to minus 10 dB. Similarly, let us say if the system is providing me the gain of 0.5, then in decibel I can write it as a 10 log of 0.5, and if you calculate it, you will get it as a minus 3 dB. So we can say that whenever the output is getting 0.5 times the input, then the gain that is being provided by the system is minus 3 dB. Or in another way, we can say that the attenuation that is being provided by the system is 3 dB. So now, so far we have seen about the power gain. Now let us talk about the voltage gain. So let us say we have an amplifier which provides me the voltage gain of, let's say, 100. That means whenever I am applying a input of, let's say, 1 volt, then at the output I am getting a 100 volt. So the gain in the decibel can be represented as 20 log of 100. So now here, if you calculate, the gain in decibel will be equal to 40 dB. Likewise, let's say if I have a gain of 1000, then in decibel it will be equal to 60 dB. Similarly, let us say if the system is providing the gain of 2, then in decibel it can be represented as 20 log of 2, and if you calculate it, it will come out as a 6 dB. So every time when the input voltage is being multiplied by the factor of 2, then we can say that the gain that is being added to the system is by 6 dB. Similarly, let us say if the system is providing the gain of 0.5, then in decibel it will be equal to 20 log of 0.5, which will come out as a minus 6 dB. So every time whenever the output voltage is half than the input voltage, then we can say that the gain that is provided by the system is minus 6 dB, or the attenuation that is being provided is 6 dB. So here is the representation of different voltage gain and corresponding gain in a decibels. So as you can see here, whenever the voltage gain is being multiplied by the factor of 2, then you will see the increase in the gain by a 6 dB. And likewise, whenever the gain is being multiplied by the factor of 0.5, then you will see the reduction in the gain by a 6 dB. And similarly, whenever the gain is being multiplied by the factor of 10, then you will see the increase in the gain by a 20 dB. And same is true for the attenuation. That means if attenuation that is provided by the factor of 10, then you will see the reduction in the gain by a minus 20 dB. So this is all about the representation of voltage and power gain in decibels. Now let us see what do we mean by this dBw, dBm and dBV. So now, so far we have represented this voltage and power gain in terms of the decibel. But what if I want to represent this power and voltage itself in a decibel scale? So of course we can represent this voltage and power in decibel scale, but as this decibel scale is the unitless quantity, so you need to represent this voltage and power in terms of the some reference. So let us say when we are representing this power in dBw form, that means we are representing this power with the reference of 1 watt. Similarly, whenever we are representing this voltage in decibel form, it means that we are representing this voltage with respect to 1 volt. So let us say if I want to represent this 10 watt of power in decibel form, then it will be equal to 10 log of P1 with respect to 1 watt. So it will come out as a 10 dB. Now here, as we are representing this power with respect to 1 watt, so after dB you will find the term that is equal to W. Similarly, let us say if I want to represent this voltage V1 of 100 volt in decibel, then it will be equal to 20 log of V1 with respect to 1 volt of voltage, and it will come out as a 40 dB. And as we are representing this voltage with respect to 1 volt of power, so after dB you will see the term that is equal to V, that is a unit of the reference voltage. So here is the different voltages which are represented in a dBv form. So now let us talk about this dBm. So whenever we are representing this any power P with respect to 1 millivolt of reference power, then it corresponds to dBm. So now let us say if I have a 100 milliwatt of power and if I want to represent it in a decibel form with respect to 1 milliwatt of power, then it can be represented as 10 log of 100 milliwatt with respect to 1 milliwatt, and that will be equal to 20 dBm. Similarly, now let us say if I want to represent 1000 milliwatt of power, or let's say 1 watt of power in dBm form, then it will be equal to 10 log of 1000 milliwatt with respect to 1 milliwatt, and that will be come out as a 30 dBm. But at the same time, suppose if I represent this power in a dBW form, then it will be equal to 10 log of 1 watt divided by 1 watt, and it will come out as a 0 dBW. So as you can see here, if the same power, if I represent it in a dBm form, then it will be equal to 30 dBm, while if I represent it in a dBW form, it will be equal to 0 dBW. So now let us say if I have some power of x dBW, and if I want to represent it in a dBm form, then simply I need to add a 30 in that particular value. So here, as we have seen, if we have a 0 dBW of power and if we want to represent it in a dBm form, then it will be equal to 0 plus 30 dBm, that is equal to 30 dBm. And same is true if we have power in dBm and if we want to represent it in a dBW form, then simply we need to subtract it by a minus 30 dBW. So I hope this conversion between dBW and dBm is clear to you. So here is the list of some powers and corresponding powers in a dBm format. Now before I end up this video, here is the question for you. Let us say if I have a power of P1 that is equal to 10 dBm and power P2 that is equal to 5 dBm, then what will be the total power P that is equal to P1 plus P2? So do let me know in the comment section below. So I hope in this video you understood the different decibel scales which are commonly used in electronics and communication system. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.